The Elmira Mammoth are still searching for their first win in franchise history. Binghamton is looking to rebound after two tough losses to Danbury last weekend, and they're missing some big players due to suspension tonight. Is tonight the night the Mammoth can put a one in the win column? Good evening, everybody. I'm Jacob Johnson here at First Arena in Elmira, New York, for another edition of the I-86 rivalry between the Elmira Mammoth and the Binghamton Black Bears. I want to welcome everybody inside First Arena here in the press box for an exciting matchup for a team, for two teams that are going to see each other a heck of a lot this year. We've already seen Binghamton twice, once down in the Vintage Veterans Memorial Arena and one time here. Let's recap last weekend for you Elmira Mammoth fans, and we'll see how they fared. In the first game on Friday against Watertown, Mo Levac scored the lone goal of that game, his first goal as an Elmira Mammoth, and they fell 6-1 against Watertown last weekend on Friday night. Now, it was a 1-0 game at the end of the first period. It was 2-0 at the end of the second period. There was a lot of chances for this team, and, you know, they a couple times on the power play, you know, 5-on-3 opportunities they didn't convert on. And then, you know, they made it a 3-1 game, and immediately after, Watertown answered back and scored some goals at the end of the third period to blow out the Elmira Mammoth 6-1. And then the following night was a different story. It was a game where the Elmira Mammoth, for the first time this season, took a 1-0 lead over their opponent. Now, shortly after, Watertown did answer back. But again, we've seen this season the Elmira Mammoth unable to answer goals. And this weekend against Watertown, they were able to do just that. Isaiah Crawford scored the first goal of the game. And then shortly following the first Watertown goal, Isaiah Crawford scored again to make it 2-1. And then a Parker Moskow goal, which made it 3-1. Elmira led going into the end of the first period. Now, Watertown, they were able to fight back, and they took a lead at the end of the second period. And it came down to the last 5 minutes of the third period, the Elmira Mammoth trailing to Watertown by a score of 5-4. With under 5 minutes to play, Parker Moskow worked through the neutral zone, played it into the corner, and then played it back for Matt Bazarian, who was sitting in front of Travis Smith, the netminder for the Watertown Wolves. And with under 5 minutes to play, the Mammoth tied it up, and that game eventually would go on to go to overtime. Now, unfortunately for the Elmira Mammoth, they fell in overtime by a score of 5-6. They did get their first point in franchise history, which, you know, they don't have 0 points in the column anymore. They do have that 1 point with the overtime loss to the Watertown Wolves. So they're looking to get it going tonight and try and put one back in the win column for themselves. Now, let's take a look at the Binghamton Black Bears. They had a rough time last weekend against the Danbury team. They are 3-2-0-1 on the season. In the last game, they lost 5-4 against Danbury in overtime. Nikita Ivashkin scored a goal. Matthew Boylar scored a goal. Jesse Anderson, as well as D'Angelo, he was able to net a goal for the Black Bears. Now, they would fall in overtime, and a lot came out of that Saturday game. And by a lot, something I mentioned right before, a lot of suspensions for this Binghamton team. They will be missing MJ Merkel tonight. They will be missing Gavin Yates tonight. Both those guys could possibly be back in the lineup tomorrow night. Gavin Yates is also dealing with an injury after a hit from Daniel Amberry from the Danbury team. Now, Cam Yarwood is the big one. He has a 5-game suspension, so we won't see him at all this weekend. And he's a guy that was able to score a goal the last time these two teams played on opening night in Binghamton. So he's a big defensive guy that they are going to be missing from this defensive group for the Black Bears. Now, you know, I talk about the team that they've matched up twice already this year. The first game of the season, a 10-1 win for the Binghamton Black Bears. Just rolling through it, Andre Vasilik scored 2 goals. Cam Yarwood with a goal. Newberg with a goal. Jesse Anderson had 2 goals. Austin Thompson had 2 goals. Gavin Yates with a goal, as well as Brett Parker, who scored. So a 10-1 game that the Elmira Mammoth, if you look at the roster from that opening night and then you look into the roster this time that they're playing them, it is a completely different group. There's only 5 guys from that roster that are still on this team right now. Completely different group right now for the Elmira Mammoth, and the lone goal was scored by a guy who's still on the team starting tonight on defense, Tom McGuire, who scored the lone goal for the Elmira Mammoth. Then the following night, the game that was the opening night here at First Arena, a 6-3 loss for Elmira. The goal scorer then was Tyler Urich, Gavin Yates, Abbott, Yvashkin, Jesse Anderson, and Austin Thompson. The Man with the Goals were scored by Lance Hamilton, Yanni Liriakos, and Justin Laporte. All three of those guys are still on the team right now for the Elmira Mammoth. But just look at the amount of points that were scored and guys that aren't in the lineup tonight for the Binghamton Black Bears. You look at a guy like Austin Thompson. He is a scratch tonight for the Black Bears. Kyle Powell had 5 points between the two games. Jesse Anderson had 4. Gavin Yates is a guy who's not in the lineup right now who had 4 points in that game. Now Tyler Jurich had 3. Nikita Ivashkin with 3. And the newly named captain of the Binghamton Black Bears, Jake Schultz, he had 3 points that game. So a good job by Binghamton. They really kept the same roster, obviously adding a couple really important guys. And these guys, JT Walters, a former Elmira enforcer, two Oswego graduates, Mac Lewis, as well as Tyson Kirkby, and a goalie, Riley McVeigh, who got his first start in between the pipes for the Black Bears last weekend against Danbury. So some additions. They are missing a couple really important pieces to the Binghamton Black Bears roster. And the Elmira Mammoth, they come in this one after playing last weekend's game as a cohesive unit, now looking to put that forward on home ice for a home weekend set against the Binghamton Black Bears. We're under 9 minutes until puck drop here in the first arena. We're going to take a quick break, but don't go anywhere. We'll have our players to watch as well as the score prediction coming up in this one. the hype video getting you ready for this one here in First Arena between the Binghamton Black Bears and the Elmira Mammoth. The Elmira Mammoth still looking for that first win in franchise history, and the Binghamton Black Bears, they come in 3-2-0-1 on the season with 8 points to their credit already this year. Under 5 minutes until puck drop, let's get to our players to watch. And my player to watch tonight for the Elmira Mammoth, now my player to watch in Watertown for the Mammoth was Isaiah Crawford. He was able to score 2 goals, so let's see if I can put that luck on another Elmira player tonight. And I'm going to go with a guy who is a former player of the Binghamton Black Bears just early on this season in Sam Halesi. Sam Halesi is a smaller forward, but he has really good speed, knows a lot what to do with the puck. He had a pass in Watertown, a beautiful backdoor setup to score the Mammoth's first goal of the game. Now, Sam Halesi from Gurnee, Illinois, he's an exciting one, and definitely look for him tonight as he tries to get it going. He's got 1 assist this season, and last year with the Black Bears, he had 6 goals and 14 assists in that one. Now, my player to watch tonight for the Binghamton Black Bears, I'm going to go with the homer of Tyson Kirkby. Tyson Kirkby, an Oswego State Laker graduate of last year. As you all know, I'm a former Oswego State guy myself, but Tyson Kirkby's a guy who was just received the A for this Binghamton team from Prescott, Ontario. He has 2 assists this season, but last year for Binghamton, he had 9 goals and 17 assists. Now he gets to play with his former teammate at Oswego, Mac Lewis, on the same line as him, and he's a guy, it's really exciting to look forward to him and see what he can do on the ice tonight for the Black Bears. I think Tyson Kirkby's a solid player. He really sets up his teammates well, and he's also a shooter. Watched him put some bar down during warm-ups today. So look for number 17, Tyson Kirkby, the assistant captain for the Binghamton Black Bears in this one. The lights have gone out. My score prediction for this one, I think tonight is the night that the Elmira Mammoth get that first win in franchise history. I think everything is setting up for that to happen tonight for them tonight. They are able to, you know, play against a team in Binghamton that are missing a couple key pieces already this year, and also they are playing as a cohesive group from last weekend. It's almost the exact same team with just a couple guys added in. So when you finally get a chance to play with the same group for the second week in a row, a full practice of playing with the same exact guys on the same line as you, I think that bodes well for this Elmira Mammoth team. So I think that they're going to get this one done today. My score prediction is going to be a 4-3 Elmira Mammoth win. I think it's going to come down to the last 10 or so minutes of the third period. The Elmira Mammoth are going to ice it away, and hopefully they're going to come home with their first win in franchise history tonight. We're 2 minutes till puck drop. There's going to be the national anthem, so everybody stay tuned for puck drop here in First Arena.
Next up, number 23, forward, Lance Hill.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, here to First Arena. My name is Jacob Johnson, and I'll be taking you through the entire 60 minutes of this FPHL matchup, the I-86 rivalry between the Elmira Mammoth and the Binghamton Black Bears. Let's take a look at the starting lineups. Looking at the net for the Binghamton Black Bears, it's going to be number 72, Owen Liskowitz. Liskowitz, a SUNY Morrisville graduate, getting the start in between the pipes. Last time we played, it was Joseph Shepard. Liskowitz comes in, 4 games played with a 2-2 record, 94 saves, 16 goals allowed, a 4.95 goals against average, and a .855 save percentage. On the other side, in between the pipes, it's Trevor McCucci for the Elmira Mammoth, and the rest of the starters, Mo Levac, Yanni Lariakos, Lance Hamilton, Tom McGuire, and a former Binghamton Black Bear in Tyler Pikarski. Gino D'Angelo getting the start for the Black Bears, as well as number 28, Matthew Boylar. Number 6, Gavin Abbott. Number 2, Eric Oganezov. And Mac Lewis also starting for the Binghamton Black Bears. We're going to get a quick icing here at 19:40 in the first period. Faceoff going to come now down into the offensive zone for the Mammoth. I mentioned Tyler Pikarski, recently traded here from the Binghamton Black Bears, starting on the defensive unit paired with Tom McGuire in this one. Going to be Levac on the draw against Mac Lewis. Levac wins, shot by Yuliriakos, that goes wide. McGuire keeps it in as he dumps the puck down, nobody there to pick it up. It's picked up by Eric Oganezov. Oganezov works through the center zone, now passes it to D'Angelo. D'Angelo enters the offense zone, and Lance Hamilton plays it up for Lyriakos. Lyriakos plays it back for McGuire. McGuire skates by McCucci, now he stops there and plays it over for Dakota Seaman. Seaman pass over for Lyriakos, that bounces off his stick. Lyriakos has it on his backhand as he skates now back behind McCucci. Plays it over for Seaman. Seaman goes off the glass looking for Levac. Seaman lays a huge body to number 21, Corey Sherman, as the Mammoth enter the zone. It's Chris Marite, shot by Lyriakos. That one goes up and into the netting. Dakota Seaman laid a massive blast in front of the Mammoth bench, and that got some woos out of the crowd here at First Arena. Brandon Beard going to be on the draw now for Elmira. It's Tyson Kirkby. That one going to be won by Beard. Maritea shoots on. That one doesn't reach Liskowitz. Kirkby passes up for Jurich. Jurich sends a pass all the way across for number 77, Jesse Anderson. Shot on McCucci. He makes a save. Beard plays it off the glass up for Dakota Seaman. Seaman plays it through the neutral zone. Skating back for it is Bazarin. Schultz the first one of that. And he plays it up for Jurich. Jurich stops at the red line, now plays it in the offense zone for Anderson. Anderson stops at the faceoff dot, backs up to the blue line. He goes for Jurich. Jurich shoots on, blocked away by McCucci. Crawford plays for Beard. Beard through the neutral zone. Beard being pressured from behind, just backhands it in, gets a change. Isaiah Crawford skating on. JT Walters picks up. Now Parker Moskal enters in. Moskal on the back of Walters. He comes away with a turnover. Moskal waits, pass out in front, nobody home. Now a 3-on-1 coming the other way for the Black Bears. Walking in, Brett Parker, pass across, beautiful move, and a goal. Nikita Ivashkin uses his speed to get by, does a deke, does a dangle, and puts it down on the backhand past Trevor McCucci. Binghamton leads this one 1-0, 17:44 to play in the first period. We've seen Ivashkin use his speed a couple times this year to get by. Ivashkin, he comes into this contest, 2 goals, 3 assists for 5 points, so his 6th point of the year and 3rd goal. Pikarski plays it off the boards for Levac. Levac has that one poked off his stick, and Mac Lewis plays up. And Pikarski played that one down with a high stick. It's going to be a faceoff in the defensive zone for Elmira. So Levac will have to take the draw against Mac Lewis. Lewis wins the draw. It's played out to the point. Shot on that one blocked by Hamilton. McGuire goes off the boards. It's kept in and dumped right back down. Picked up by Hamakuchi by Abbott. Abbott tried to throw out in front, but Piekarski right there. Now a battle along the near side boards. Piekarski, the first one to get to it, plays it all the way across. And it's dumped right back down. Lewis sends it out in front. Backhand shot. That one goes up and over. Lewis out to the point. Played down into the near side corner. Now McGuire. McGuire picks up behind Micucci. Goes off the boards looking for Hamilton. It's kept in again. Now Hamilton has that stolen by Lewis. Lewis shoots on. That one deflected wide to Micucci. Battle along the near side boards here. Comes out to the point for Boylard. He shoots on save. Now it's right through the center. Hamilton plays up for Lyriakos. Lyriakos goes for McGuire. McGuire has that pass tipped off his stick and played back in the defense zone goes Boylard. Stolen by Beard. Beard enters the offensive zone. He tries to make a move by it, but it's stolen by Oganezov. Through the neutral zone goes Jesse Anderson. Anderson with a pass for Kirkby. Kirkby sends it out front. Shot on that one. Pushed away by Micucci with the pads. Another shot. Sticked away by Micucci. Bazarin picks up. He clears the zone. It comes down. Oganezov picks up. 16 minutes remaining here in the first period. 1-0 Binghamton leads. Kirkby plays it for Boylar. Boylar. Pass for George, who enters the offense zone. Now Anderson. Anderson on the backhand shot. Micucci makes the save. Kirkby goes hard into the boards now. Boylar. Boylar shoots on that one wide of the netminder. It's kept in by Oganezov. Oganezov and Dakota Seaman battling. Now a shot, that one goes up and over. Shot coming from Tyler Jurich. Pass right out in front, it hops off the stick of Jurich, now goes wide. Bazarin tries to clear the zone. Seaman lays another massive hit in front of the Mammoth bench. Now Jurich makes a move by Shana. Huge save, Micucci. Kirkby had a wide open net. Kirkby out to the point, Boylar. Boylar skates in, has it on his backhand. His shot doesn't get through. Now coming the other way is Tate Leeson. Leeson, new addition to the Elmira Mammoth squad. Plays off for Moskal. Moskal shoots on, that one's blocked. He tried to send it out in front, nobody home. Now Nikita Ivashkin. Ivashkin using his speed. Has that one poked off his stick by Isaiah Crawford. 3-on-3 goes the other way in the Mammoth. Crawford makes a move by. He tries to split the defenders, but he's held up. Now the other way goes JT Walters. Walters crosses the red line and dumps it in the far side corner. Tim Plain tries to play it through. Parker Moskal has that one bounce off his stick. Ivashkin plays it. What a pass for Leeson in the neutral zone. Leeson using his speed. He goes for Moskal. Moskal down the near side. As he walks down low. Shoots on it, scores! Parker Moskal goes short side on Owen Liskowitz. And it's 1-1. Parker Moskal just walking into the offensive zone, goes down low, shoots on, and Liskowitz thought he had every hole and avenue covered up, but Parker Moskal found a way through the street and puts it through, and it's 1-1 here. For Parker Moskal, it's his third goal of the season and 12th point. And we have a tie ball game here, folks, 14-19 to play in the first period. Now it's Lyriakos. Lyriakos enters the offensive zone. He shoots on, Liskowitz makes the save, still loose out in front. And cleared down by Binghamton. It's gonna go all the way down by Micucci. He raises his hand, and we're gonna get an icing call. So the second shot of the game that Owen Liskowitz was forced to face, he ends up letting it in the back of the net. Levac wins the draw. It's played out to Piekarski. Piekarski goes down low for Levac. Levac holds it off the boards. Now being pressured by Binghamton. It comes out. Going the other way is Mac Lewis. Lewis enters the offensive zone. He's pushed off the puck there by Piekarski. Piekarski shields his body away. Plays it up for Lyriakos. Lyriakos still in the defensive zone. Now flips it all the way up. Lance Hamilton skates on. Hamilton in the far side corner. Pass out in front, looking for Maguire, too far from him. Lewis plays off the boards in front of the Binghamton bench now. Coming the other way is Speed, as we're going to get a call. It's going to be on Lyriakos, and it's going to be hooking. He knew right away. So Yanni Lyriakos going to head to the penalty box here. So a two-minute power play coming up for Binghamton. The Mammoth 73% this year on the penalty kill. And with that, it looks like we're going to get our under 15 media timeout here. With 13:23 to play, we're going to take a quick break, but don't go anywhere. Binghamton Power Play next. So the power play unit now out for Binghamton. It's going to be Tyson Kirkby who takes the draw. It's played out for Jurich. Jurich can't keep it in. Now Sam Halesi. Halesi with speed. He skates on. Halesi looking for a short-handed goal. He shoots on. That one goes wide. Moscow loses that one. Now Binghamton takes back over as they play through the neutral zone. It's Jake Schultz. Schultz, the new captain of the Binghamton squad, plays for Kirkby at the point. That shot goes wide. That one's going to go up into the netting. And we'll get a face-off. It's going to be Schultz. Schultz goes for Anderson. Anderson leaves it off now for Schultz to Kirkby at the point. Kirkby fakes a slap shot. Now walks in. Shot that goes wide to Micucci. Jurich goes back out for Kirkby. Kirkby for Schultz. Shot on that one's blocked by Noah Wild. And Sam Halesi clears the zone. Now Schultz with 1:05 left here on the power play. Kirkby keeps it at the point. Stolen by Brandon Beard. Now Liskowitz covers up. Tate Leeson with snow in the face. And 54 seconds left. Face-off going to be won by Binghamton as they work through the neutral zone. It's Ivashkin. Ivashkin quick with it down into the near side corner. 36 seconds remaining on the power play for Binghamton. Tate Leeson tries to get out of the zone, and it's played down low. Cleared by Brandon Beard as that goes all the way down. Now working through the offensive zone. And shooting on that one, blocked it away by Micucci. Lance Hamilton plays it up for Levesque. Levesque through the neutral zone on his backhand as he skates after it. Liskowitz comes out of his net to play it, backhands it, and wraps it along the boards. 10 seconds remaining on the Yanni Lyriakos penalty. 1-1 game, 11:28 here in the first period. Now D'Angelo. D'Angelo stops at the faceoff dot, sends it out in front.